Hey folks, this is Best in Slot. Welcome to the next Jurassic World Evolution 2 feature focus, this time focused on customization. And that is customization of your buildings, of your parks, of the terrain, and indeed of your dinosaurs as well. There's some pretty cool stuff coming up. Although I'll say most of it is just text. We only got one new screenshot we're going to be reading and discussing. No big flashy images or something, I'm afraid, but there is one cool screenshot. So we're going to kick things off talking about building customization. In Jurassic World Evolution 2, we're introducing guest building customization. This new feature lets you edit and change your guest buildings on the fly, allowing you to add your own mark to your parks with unique looks and further personalization. Not much to say about this one, so I'll draw a smiley face and we'll move on with our lives. Guest buildings are split into two types, amenities and attractions. So amenities are your restaurants and your shops in general, and attractions is we've seen things like an aquarium. It's not actually going to show aquarium creatures, we assume, but it's called an aquarium. Amenities come in small, medium and large size, which determines their overall capacity. Customizing these buildings can be done internally and externally, which serve different purposes. We'll cover internal modifications first and then move on to external customization. By internal modification, it doesn't mean we're going to go inside the buildings and change things up. I'm still pretty sure the buildings are empty shells, just like my heart. Your guests have different interests and different people will be attracted to different areas of your parks based on their interests. You can change a guest building's internal modules to better cater to these interests and maximize your profits. Keep in mind that the internal modules aren't visible from the outside and won't change the look of the building itself, but will change what sort of guests the building primarily cater to. From steakhouses for adventurers to bowling alleys for nature lovers, the choice is yours. Are nature lovers particularly big on bowling? I don't know, maybe they are. So let's discuss what exactly this means. Let's say you have a medium amenity. There it is, our medium amenity. From the outside it looks like an absolutely blank box. There's nothing going on, it's just a box. Your internal customization, as far as we can tell, is going to be a box that you click. You click a button and then you'll get like a drop down menu and it'll have, you know, your steak, it'll have your different food items, it'll have your different shops, your restaurants, your gift shops, stuff like that. Now guests in Jurassic World Evolution 2 are split into four categories. You've got your luxury, your adventurers, your nature lovers, and your basics, basically. And it seems that each of those different shops will cater to those different guests in different amounts. So I think this will tie in really well with the dinosaurs. Let's say, right, this is your dinosaur, you've got a dinosaur over here, and you've got a T-Rex, which is big. It's got a massive erection. You've got a T-Rex. Sorry. It was meant to be an arm. You've got your T-Rex and that caters to adventurers because it's a big, large, brash carnivore. So you know that more than 25% of the guests that go to the T-Rex are going to be adventurers because that's what they're attracted to. So in the shop next to the T-Rex, what you would do is you would pick the internal module that better suits adventurers because they're more likely to go and spend a lot of money at that restaurant, at that gift shop, at that whatever it is that caters to those guests. So this is all internal and this seems to be entirely about knowing which shops to put where to best cater to the dinosaurs. It's actually quite a cool little management aspect, I would say. It's a nice little bit of depth when usually you could just stick the same three shops all over the park. Now we have to actually be a little bit picky and we actually have to use our brains, which is terrifying. The outside of your guest buildings can be modified in a variety of ways to add that personal touch. With the click of a button, you can cycle through different looks for the building facade, the roof and potential roof decorations, entrance style and location, and different types of outside signage and decorations. We've seen some of those already, like the Spinosaurus skull, for example. By mixing and matching different styles, you can quickly find something that works best for you and your parks. You've already seen a small sample of this in the thumbnail for this very feature focus, and we'll look at that in a couple of slides. I am curious about one thing. If we have our empty shell, and I make this a salad shop internally, but on the outside I have like a logo for steak, will it, like, is that possible? Can we mix and match the logo from completely different shops, since they do seem to be different systems, or will setting the internal type of shop then lock us into the right logo for the exterior? I'd be very curious. I quite like the idea of tricking my guests. You wanted steak? No, you'll have a Cobb salad. But yeah, this basically works exactly how we predicted. It's going to be lots of menus, and you're going to click something, and then you'll get like several options. So this will say like roof decoration or something like that, and you'll have an option for plants or lights or an umbrella or whatever. You'll have various different options, and you'll be able to select various different places and select the items that go there. You can further alter your guest buildings by changing the coloration. Contrasting and complementary colors on the facade will make your build. I appreciate the seal on the facade as well. Will make your buildings truly stand out from their surroundings. You can also change the color of the roofs, decorations, and even lights. Hopefully, so I think lights are like a toggle option, they're not just there by default, it's like, it's something you add on the roof, something you add on the outside, by the entrance, etc. And hopefully, changing the colour of the lights will actually change the colour of the lights, it won't just be like the bulb changing colour, but the lights it emits, because then we could do really cool themed areas. I can actually build like a Halloween park. It's designed to be flexible and offer players a quick and easy way to put a personal touch on their parks. And I've got to be honest, it sounds pretty cool. So that's about it for the buildings themselves, although we do have a little picture here. You can see it in action. All of these are barbecue grills. There are a lot of these logos. We've seen tons of these, like 8, 9, 10 of these already. I will at some point go and track them all down so we know what they all are. But you can see how all these different barbecue grills, you know, you want a barbecue grill for your shop, whatever, but they all look entirely different. They've all got a completely different building shape. The logo is even in a different place across the buildings. It's really cool. It's a really nice level of customization without having to go through the level of tedium and intricate detailing that you need to do for a Prehistoric Kingdom, a Planet Zoo, a Planet Coaster. Not that there's anything wrong with that, but I don't think it suits Jurassic World Evolution. I think this is the right way to tackle it for Evolution. And we finally get all that customization we so badly wanted in the past game. And they are vastly different looking buildings. It's really cool. And then hopefully there's some color customization going on here as well. Maybe these lights out here, I don't know. Before we move on, cheeky little thing, just look down there. Oh, there's a chair. Oh, I wonder what that's all about. We'll come back to that in a little bit. Moving on. So, away from the buildings and onto some of the other stuff very briefly. Park customization. Guest buildings aren't the only way you'll be adding a personal touch to your parks. In Jurassic World Evolution 2, we're expanding your options for decorating and customizing your parks! You will be able to add a variety of decorations to your parks, word parks far too many times today already, and quickly add in forests, shrubbery, and terrain surfaces with the game's quick and easy tools, nothing there new from Evolution 2 in particular. Your terrain tools will let you raise, lower, flatten, and smooth the landscape, just like the past ones. And one of our goals during development has been to implement more control for landscape shaping and a greater variety of brush sizes. You won't be able to recreate Mount Sebo, but you will have a little more control over the shape and look of the landscape with the terrain tools and surface brushes. So basically, it sounds like we're going to have bigger brushes, littler brushes, and whilst we're not going to be able to make a full-on sharp magic massive mountain, it does say implement more control for landscape shaping, and it has that as separate from greater variety of brush sizes, so I'm hoping what that means is we can just build slightly sharper cliffs. I think everyone who's played Evolution has been through this, wherein you try to build a ledge or a cliff or like just a ledge, and it always turns into like this really gradual massive hill. So being able to have sharper inclines would be really cool, really nice thing to have, and hopefully, whilst I don't think it's going to be crazy, you know, just a little bit more control in that respect would be awesome. So instead of this, which is what we get right now, even just something like that would be cooler, right? That would be a big step in the right direction. Surface brushes let you paint the terrain with sand and rocks to mud and gravel. And once you're happy with the surface terrain, you can start adding in freestanding bushes, rocks, and trees. We've seen many of you asking if there are decorations coming in Jurassic World Evolution 2. Short answer, yes. Tables and chairs, hence the chairs earlier, lights, banners, planters, can all be added to your parks. You won't be able to build elaborate blueprints and designs like in Planet Zoo or Planet Coaster, but we know decorations are important to the community, and you will be able to add a little extra flair to your parks. That is, again, a big, big deal. It's a bit silly that it's a big deal, if we're honest, but it is indeed a big deal. I don't think anyone really was asking for this. We don't want elaborate designs and stuff like that, but just some basic items we can chuck into the park, onto our paths, into the general area, to make it look more like an actual park, and again, to give us that little bit of creative control. It's a humongous upgrade. Tables, chairs, lights in particular, hopefully. Just give me a few lights, make them customizable like the ones in the buildings, and I will be happy forever. banners and planters all added to your parks. Yeah, that's really cool. If I had to wager a guess, I don't think they'll be guest interactable like the tables and chairs. That would be my personal assumption, but we'll have to wait and see. But honestly, just having them there is a huge step in the right direction. It really is. It also sounds like we might be getting more surface terrain. We already had sand, we already had rock, we already had mud slash dirt, really. Gravel we sort of had, but mainly on Isla Pena we had like the shale, so maybe that's been added as a separate one. It'd be nice to have a few more terrain options, one or two more. It didn't feel like a big problem in Evolution, that one, but you know, a couple more options is always a good thing. Now for the dinosaurs, this is pretty exciting as well. We touched briefly on genetic modification of dinosaurs in our last feature focus, and we'd be remiss not to mention dinosaur cosmetic genes this week. Changing your dinosaur's cosmetic genes will allow you to change their appearance in two different ways: pattern and coloration. You've already seen a few examples of this in screenshots and species field guides. The next bit is the big bit. You will be able to select from several different patterns per dinosaur species. We believe that's 7 based on the article, and this will determine what markings they have. So, an extra crest pattern, doppling on the legs, blah 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 blah. Once you've set the pattern, you can change the colour of the pattern and the base colour of the dinosaur. Coloration is selected from a set of different colour options, we believe that's 12. And while you won't be able to make a fluorescent pink T-Rex, unfortunately, you will have a wide variety of different combinations and patterns and colorations to choose from. So, if the numbers we believe are correct are indeed correct, in that there's 7 patterns and 12 colors for the base dinosaur, maybe we can assume there's 12 colors for the pattern as well, the same 12 colors, basically. So you could have like a... We'll do a little drawing first before I do that bit. So you got your Triceratops. There it is. And you colour your Triceratops in yellow, and maybe there's a pattern like this at the back, and you colour that in yellow as well if you want it quite subtle, or you make that black, or you make this black and that yellow. If that's true, and it's 7 patterns, 12 colours, and 12 colours per pattern, that is 1,008 different possible colour combinations per each individual dinosaur, which is utter bloody madness. Maybe the patterns don't have 12 colours, maybe the article was wrong in the first place, but if those numbers are correct, it's 1,008. Now, it's not necessarily going to be a big deal. Maybe, you know, you've got 2 Triceratopses, there you go, and this one's yellow, and this one's yellow, and this one's got a black crest, and this one's got like a red crest or something. They're not all going to be drastically different, but it's like little minute differences. It's going to be really good for making herds with a specific alpha, or to make our own gender dimorphism up, or just have special dinosaurs, or I don't know. It's really good. It's just extra levels of everything from the past game, basically. You know, they've taken... It's a sequel. It does what a sequel should do, essentially. We hope you've enjoyed this brief look into the different ways you can add a unique touch to your dinosaurs, parks, and guest buildings. Which part are you most excited to get your hands on? Is it customizable guest buildings, or maybe the wider range of skin patterns and colours? Sound off in the comments and let us know. Until the next feature focus, you can follow us on links that obviously won't work for you guys and join the discussions on the forums. So that is it for the second feature focus. A very exciting one. This customization looks really cool. I'm going to spend a lot of time theming my buildings, especially if the lights color customizable. That's a huge deal to me just because of who I am. You know, maybe you want all your barbecue places to look the same. Maybe they look different at different elevations, or you've got themed areas of your park. It's just a little bit more control. And those of you who watch me a lot will know player control is a really important thing to me, so this is really exciting, and I do think this is the right way to do it. I think we were never going to get Planet Zoo, Planet Coaster levels of customization. That was just never going to be on the cards. But this level of customization, easily accessible from drop-down menus and stuff, yeah, I'm excited. Let me know what you think in the comment section down below. Hit the like button if you're excited about this part of Evolution 2, or if you like hearing me rabble on about nonsense. Either or, whichever works for you. Subscribe if you're new to the channel and want the latest in Evolution 2 news. And that is it from me. Thank you so much for joining me. I'll see you lovely folks next time. Cheers, much love as always. Bye-bye. Reaching out.